Yeah, here, basically, this chapter starts with the force on a conductor. Nana. Means suppose this is one current carrying conductor, carrying some current I. Okay. First of all, that current carrying conductor produces how much magnetic field? Okay. This one you know as Biot-Savart's law. Okay. The Biot-Savart's law never gives the magnetic field due to the whole element. That gives only due to a small element of current carrying conductor. So that always gives due to one small element of length L, dl, the magnetic field at a point which is at a distance of r from the element, making an angle some theta. Keep in mind that theta you did not measure with the current carrying conductor, you measured with the direction of current flow. Okay, that is very important while solving the numericals. Means what I mean here is, suppose this current carrying conductor carries the current downwards, not upwards, then at the same point due to the same element here, okay, I have to measure the angle with the line joining, okay, here, not the angle what I measured, this is not the angle, I have to measure with the direction of current. With the direction of current means I have to measure the angle theta here. Okay. So due to the element or due to this element, depending upon the direction of current, we have to change the angles what we measure. The magnetic field here dB is equals to, you know that formula, which is mu naught by 4 pi I dl sine theta by r square, where r is the distance. Okay, and the direction of force, magnetic field is generally we measure with the most useful right hand thumb rule. Number, suppose it carries the current upwards, the magnetic field will be into, here depending upon the direction of current, the magnetic field will be into, here downwards means other side into, and that side where we are measuring, you are getting the magnetic field outwards. So here outwards you will get. Okay. Using this formula, here if you take one finite straight conductor carrying the current I, okay, suppose you are going to find out the magnetic field induction at a point, of course at a distance r. Here, at this point, the magnetic field B is equals to, by integrating this formula, finally we have to substitute the limits, Nana, like this. Okay. What are, suppose with the conductor, actually according to the theory, we have to measure the angle with the direction of current, means I have to measure this angle, Nana. Okay. This angle I have to measure. Here with the direction of current, the line joining makes an angle. This angle I have to take on the other side. Suppose this is theta 1 and I gave here the angle as theta 2, inner angle. Okay, after integrating, actually you have to get the formula mu naught by 4 pi I by r, means I am not integrating that formula directly, I am giving the formula here, mu naught by 4 pi I by r into, actually you will get cos theta after integrating. Okay, in that theta we have to substitute one angle is theta 1, okay, other angle is actually 180 minus theta 2. Okay, why? Because I have to substitute the angle here. Okay, whereas I took the inner angle as theta 2, so the angle to be substituted is 180 minus theta 2. So after substituting, you will get mu naught by 4 pi I by r into here cos theta minus cos 180 minus theta 2 is minus cos theta 2. That you will get minus of minus plus now. This will be the final formula what you have to use. And here don't get confused, Nana. In your material they may give the angles measured at the point. Okay, this formula is correct. And here in your material means few materials, they follow other angles here. Suppose I took these two angles as theta 1 and theta 2. And here you take the angles at the point where you are going to find out the magnetic field. I have to take these angles as, if it is theta 1, then the angle here, suppose if you take it as phi 1 should be 90 minus theta 1. And here the angle, let it be phi 2. And that phi 2 will be 90 minus theta 2 nana. Okay. So in this formula, same formula, if you substitute these two angles, phi 1 and 1 2, substitute these two angles, phi 1 and phi 2, then mu naught by 4 pi, I have to write I by R into cos theta 1. I have to substitute as 90 minus phi 1. Okay. And here plus cos theta 2. Theta 2 is 90 minus phi 2. Then you will get another formula that I think it will be there in your material. Mu naught by 4 pi. Here I have to write this one as in terms of sine. So sine phi 1 plus sine phi 2. Okay. So both are correct, Nana. But you have to take care where you are measuring the angles. At the conductor, you will get cos function. At the point, you will get sine function. Okay. Out of these two, generally I prefer this formula, Nana, cos formula. Why? Because to apply this one in few numericals, like suppose if you take the previous mains question, this is one equilateral triangle, Nana, what he gave, okay, in 2018. And suppose it is one closed loop carrying the current I like this. Okay. And each side you take it as L. And if they ask what will be the magnetic field induction due to the closed triangular loop at the centroid. Okay. If they ask, look at Nana, the each element, if you consider each element is a finite straight conductor. Finite straight conductor means that is the application of what the formula we took here. Okay. So here that straight conductor, look at the point or at the conductor, look at, you only see there. It will be very easy to say the angles at the conductor. Okay. It is equilateral triangle. So total angle will be 60 degrees. So half of the angle will be 30 degrees here. Each angle very easily I can say. And here the perpendicular distance from the from us side is just like the distance from base to centroid. Base to centroid, this distance is, I think all of you know, if each side length is L, that will be L by 2 root 3. Okay. From vertex to centroid is L by root 3. Base to centroid is L by 2 root 3. Okay. So you know the distance, you know the angles. So due to one element means one conductor, the magnetic field you can find B is equals to, according to my formula, mu naught by 4 pi I by R. Okay. Where R is here, the distance from the conductor, that is perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance from the conductor. I found here as L by 2 root 3 into, I have to write what, cos theta 1 cos 30 plus cos theta 2 cos 30. Okay. Or else you can write here, if you want to use this formula, I have to take the angles at the point. This angle will be 60, that angle also will be 60. So I have to write it as sine 60 plus sine 60. Both are one and the same only now. So B1 will be, you will get mu naught by 4 pi I by L into 2 root 3 into cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 is root 3. Okay. That you will get, Nana, mu naught by 4 pi I by L into 2 into root 3 is 3. 3 to the 6 you will get. It is not the answer, Nana. That is the magnetic field due to only one element. Okay. Whereas the closed loop has three sides. due to one side you form the magnetic field. Due to second side and third side also the magnitude will be same. Why? Because this is equilateral triangle, all side lengths are equal. So all the perpendicular distances are equal. All the angles measured at the center also equal. Okay. So angles are equal, perpendicular distances, distances are equal, current also same. That's why you will get same magnitudes, Nana. And if you see the direction, you will get the magnetic field on the other side outwards. Whereas at the point, you will get into here. This conductor also gives the magnetic field into. Whereas the third one also gives the current, current in this direction gives the magnetic field into only. So the three elements using the right hand thumb rule, if you check, you will get inwards only. Means all the three are giving inwards. So the magnetic field induction here, all are in the same direction. Same direction means the net magnetic field, you can write it as B1 plus B2 plus B3. Okay, which is equals to, since the magnitudes are equal here, you can write it as 3B1. Okay, understood? So from there, you can write the magnetic field induction at the center B equals to, this is 3/6 of 18 mu naught I by 4 pi L. Okay, this is the magnetic field induction at the centroid of a triangular loop. Okay, the same model I think yesterday you asked from your material. Okay, that is due to a square loop. Okay. Due to a square loop means actually you ask this type of model. Okay. So here, if it is a square loop, right, then it will be very easy. Nana. Why? Because perpendicular distance is exactly half of the side length. If you take the side length as L, half of the length means L by 2. Carrying the current, suppose clockwise, you will get all into only the magnetic field. So the net magnetic field I have to write due to 1, 2, 3, 4 sides, 4B1. Okay. Where B1 is equals to what can you write? According to our Biot-Savart's law, mu naught by 4 pi. From there, we derived the formula mu naught by 4 pi. I by R is L by 2. Into cos, my formula, cos theta 1 here will be 45 degrees. Nana. Other side also you will get 45 degrees. Okay. So cos 45 plus cos 45 I have to write. Okay. Which is mu naught I by 2 pi L after cancelling 2 times here. Cos 45 plus cos 45, 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 is 2 by root 2. 2 by root 2 is root 2. Okay, therefore B net straight away in easy way you can write it as 4 times, that is a 4 root 2 into mu naught I by 2 pi L. Okay, sir, if one side is cut, sir, like the problem given in our assignment, sir. Okay, there he gave only 3 sides, sir. No problem, ma'am. 3 sides are given means just you take here B net is equal to 3 times to B1. Means in the same way here I have to write instead of 4, 3. 3 root 2 into mu naught I by 2 pi L. That's it. Okay. This is the magnetic field induction concept, Nana. Due to, means I gave here 2 examples related to how to find the magnetic field induction. Okay. Using the concept of the magnetic field due to a finite conductor. Okay. And here, suppose if it is infinite or semi-infinite. Okay. Not finite, sir. Finite, we know the formulas are in terms of cause or sun. Suppose if you take semi-infinite, what is the meaning of semi-infinite? Semi-infinite means one end we know, other end is infinite law. Okay. Then suppose here at a perpendicular distance, say R, okay, what is the magnetic field induction? If I ask, keep in mind, I am measuring the angles with the conductor, okay, So I am going far away from the point means look at the angle measured here with the conductor gradually decreases. That angle gradually decreases and when you go to infinite end, that angle tends to zero. If you want to measure the angle at the point, that angle tends to infinite. Sorry, 90. Okay, anyone you can use now. So here the magnetic field induction at the point means if you know the angles here, okay, this angle at infinite angle and at infinite end means where I am measuring with the conductor, theta 1 tends to 0, and here with the conductor, the line joining makes an angle here theta 2 equals to 90. Means again you have formula. What is B is equals to mu naught I by 4 pi r into cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2. Okay. So due to semi-infinite straight conductor, you will get the formula mu naught I by 4 pi r into cos 0 is 1 only. You will get that formula. Okay. That is due to semi-infinite straight conductor. Okay. In this semi-infinite straight conductor, sir, like this, semi-infinite means one end is infinite, other end is known, but the point I am taking not at the perpendicular distance, sir. Suppose if I take the point like this, means I want the magnetic field induction here, B is equals to how much? Very simple, Nana. Here again, the perpendicular distance is R in this formula. So from the wire means extend this wire, Nana, okay? And here you take the perpendicular distance as r in this model, right? And the angle, take care, other end is infinite. So theta 1 tends to 0 and theta 2, once again I am repeating, we have to measure with the conductor, okay? So I am taking the current downwards. So with the direction of current, the line joining makes an angle, let it be theta, okay? Again, you can write here B due to this semi-infinite when the point is not on the perpendicular line, then B is equals to mu naught I by 4 pi r into cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2 you have to write. That is mu naught I by 4 pi r into 1 plus cos theta 2. Since theta 2 is a obtuse angle, Nana, surely you will get here some negative value, like a cos 135, you will get minus 1 by root 2. Okay. Same thing if they ask like, suppose it is semi-infinite straight conductor, okay. Semi-infinite means at the infinite end, you know the angle is zero, but the point somewhere here I select, okay? Then here again, it is the perpendicular distance R, and here the angle with the other end, this is theta 1, okay? Sorry, theta 2 with the direction of current, okay? So that is theta 2. And that inside angle is theta 2 if you know, then look at same formula you will get. B is equals to mu naught I by 4 pi r into cos theta 1, cos 0 is 1, plus cos theta 2. The only difference between these two, formula wise they are appeared to be same number. Okay. But when you come to numericals, you will get some negative value here and you will get some positive value there. That is the only difference between the two models. Okay. And then here both ends are infinite. This one all of you know. Okay. Which is called as infinite straight conductor. Okay. If it is infinite straight conductor and the point is at a distance of r, perpendicular distance from the conductor, then at infinite end, the angle already I told. Okay. With the conductor, tends to zero. Here also with the conductor tends to zero. Okay. This is B is equals to mu naught I by, if you substitute here 4 pi r into cos theta 1 is cos 0 1 plus cos theta 2 is also cos 0 1. 1 plus 1 you will get 2. 2, 2 times cancel here. You will get mu naught I by 2 pi r. Okay. And here, any doubts, Nana, in this concept? Right. Then, here, suppose if you select one point like this, suppose this is one infinite state conductor or finite state conductor. Okay, anyone, either infinite or finite. Okay, anyone if you take and I select one point like this. Okay, look at that point is appeared on the axis of the conductor. On the axis of the conductor, in any numerical manner, take care the magnetic field is equals to zero. Okay, don't try to argue, sir, here if I take one point on the axis means on the conductor, then the perpendicular distance should be zero, sir. If r is equals to zero, then I should get b infinity, sir. Why you wrote zero there? Okay, that I will explain, ma'am. B equals to zero. Even if it is finite conductor, the magnetic field on the conductor means on the axis of conductor equals to zero. Okay, these type of models you may get, ma'am. Where, sir, suppose this is one conductor, okay, bent like this. Like yesterday, what you have. Yesterday in your problem, he gave this is the point, find out the magnetic field induction at that point. Okay. If I ask find the magnetic field induction at this point instead of the model given in your assignment, if I ask due to these infinite state conductors or finite state conductors, you can say the answer. Due to this part, it is on the axis. So B1 straight away you can say zero. And here it is also, if you extend this line, it is on the axis. So B3 is also equals to zero. Then you have to find out due to these three parts. Okay. Those three parts means, I think, you know, due to first part, the angle here with the conductor is 90 degrees. The other angle, depending upon the distance, we have to find out. Suppose it is a square loop, then you know it is A by 2 and this is A. Okay. Then the angle here will be, suppose some theta, then tan theta equals to, you can write here, it has opposite side by adjacent side, that is half. So tan theta is half means you can write cos theta is equals to how much. Okay. Tan theta is half. So cos theta means you can write it as 2 by root 5. Okay. In the same way, you can find the magnetic field due to the second element. Okay. Here, finding out the angles there. And again, what is the magnetic field induction? Due to the third element also, we have to find. One angle is 90 degrees, other angle we have to find. Using the same right angle triangle concept. Okay. So this is one example. If you take a point on the axis of a straight conductor, okay, and then here, until now, what the models we discussed, anywhere we did not consider the dimensions of the conductor. Dimension means what will be the radius of the conductor. We are just drawing one line and we are seeing that it is a conductor. It's okay. What will be the radius? Not mentioned. Okay. If they mention the radius like this, okay, here, suppose this is one infinite state conductor and here the radius of conductor is r and it is the axis of the conductor, what I am saying. Okay. And both ends are extend to infinite distance. And if I ask what is the magnetic field induction at a point, now we have to say clearly whether you are going to find out outside the conductor or on the conductor or at a point inside the conductor. Okay. So if I ask outside the conductor, then immediately you can use the formula N phi state conductor already we derived by considering it as a thin line, mu naught I by 2 pi r. There is no argument here. Okay. And if I ask what is the magnetic field induction on the surface of conductor, okay, on the surface of conductor means the distance is equal to the radius. So here also there is no second thought. Straight away you can say mu naught I by 2 pi capital R. Okay. If I ask what is the magnetic field induction inside the conductor, then how to derive, sir? Okay. Then, Nana, here, suppose if it is one infinite straight conductor and it is the axis, and I am asking here at a distance of r, what is the magnetic field induction? Then you have to use by changing this one as Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's circuital law means by cross multiplying for infinite state conductor B into 2 pi r is equals to mu naught times 2 I. 2 pi r means here around a straight current carrying conductor generally magnetic field will be in the circular path. Means around the conductor here the magnetic field is formed as concentric circles. Concentric circle means at a distance of r, at a distance of r from the conductor, okay, 2 pi r is nothing but length of that circle, that is perimeter. So here around that conductor, it is the circle where you are going to find out the magnetic field induction. At all points same, Nana, B is same, okay. So if you assume a small element here, the you can write it as 2 pi r, Nana, there. Okay. So straight away you can write it as b into integral dl. You are taking the closed integration. So you can put one circle also here for to represent it is closed integration. Is equals to mu naught times 2 I. You can write. Okay. Keep in mind the conductor is inside this circle, Nana. Inside the circle means this I is the current present inside that closed loop. Okay. Using that formula, you can find out the magnetic field induction at a point inside. Okay. Means here at a distance of r. Okay. If you construct a circle here, then the magnetic, using the Ampere's circuital law, you can write here B into closed integral of dl, which is nothing but equals to 2 pi small r. Okay, where small r is not equal to the radius, is equals to mu naught times 2, we have to write I present inside. That is equals to how much? Okay, look at it is carrying the current, Nana. Carrying the current means through this cross section, like through a pipe, how the water flows. Here through this conductor, the current flows. Current means nothing but what flow of electrons. The electrons flow. Okay, of course in opposite direction. So this is the current flow. That current flow is actually through a cross section of radius capital R. Whereas you require the cross section of radius only small r. That's why here how to measure, sir? Since the current is uniformly flowing through the pipe, for uniform flow you can say for pi r square cross section the current is I. Then for pi small r square cross section what will be the current? Okay, then directly you can say what the current inside is equals to by taking here I into pi r square divided by pi r square. Okay, using the cross multiplication concept. So I into here r square by r square you are getting. So I inside is equals to I write here I r r square. Okay, then you will get here the magnetic field induction at a point inside. Okay, if you see B is equals to B into 2 pi r equals to I write here mu naught times 2 I present inside I got I r square by capital R. So one r get cancelled here, Nana. Then B is equals to you are getting what mu naught I r by 2 pi capital R square. Keep in mind. Okay, there you can check. If you come onto the surface, small r is equals to capital R. If you put small r is equal to capital R, 1r get cancelled. Again, you will get the formula mu naught I by 2 pi r, what we got here. Okay, that is the formula. And from this formula, you can see what inside a conductor at a point, B is directly proportional to the distance. Okay, so that r suppose becomes zero means coming onto the axis. When r is equals to 0, you can say b is equals to 0. Okay, this point what I told here, this is considered as axis. On the axis of strike conductor, since r is equals to 0, b is equals to 0. Okay, so whatever you know here, b is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r is used only when the point is selected outside the conductor, provided the dimensions are mentioned to you in your numeric. Okay, so here related to this concept, one year he asked what will be the shape of the graph in mains exam. Okay, means for this conductor, inside at all points, we found B is directly proportional to R means the graph you will get by taking B on Y axis and distance on X axis. Directly proportional means it is a straight line passing through origin. So you will get a straight line like this passing through horizon. And here when you come onto the surface means at a distance r is equals to r. Okay. Here the magnetic field will be maximum, which is mu naught I by 2 pi r. This is B max. So in numericals, due to a straight conductor, find out the maximum magnetic field. Then you can say the formula is mu naught I by 2 pi r, infinite state conductor. And when you come outside, it is inversely proportional to r. Okay, whereas mu naught I by 2 pi r constants. Inversely proportional to r means perfect rectangular hyperbola u. Okay, so this is the shape of the graph for the magnetic field, how it changes with the distance from the axis of the conductor, provided the dimensions of conductor, dimension, the radius of conductor is given to you. Okay, this is all the story related to the straight conductor on a finite and infinite. Okay, in this whole concept, finite and infinite. Okay, then here again, if we come to, if it is not straight conductor, sir, if it is suppose a circular loop. Okay, means suppose here this is one circular loop, Nana. Okay, due to the circular loop, what will be the magnetic field induction at the center and what will be the magnetic field induction if you take the loop perpendicular to the plane of the board? Here, what will be the magnetic field induction on the axial line? Okay. These two actually I am not deriving, Nana. Why? Because they are IP concepts. They are already derivations also given in your IP textbook. So straight away, whatever you know, I write here. B is equals to mu naught I R square by 2 into R square plus R square whole power 3 by 2. Where capital R is the radius I am taking here in my formula. And a small r is nothing but the distance from the center. Okay, and if it is not a loop, if it is a coil, okay, then for a coil, B is equals to, coil means it has n number of closed loops now. Then B is equals to, you have to write mu naught I R square into, for n loops, into n, by 2 into R square plus R square whole power 3 by 2. Okay, and if you come to the center of this closed loop, means circular loop, then you can say here by putting small r equals to 0, you are coming to the center, small r equals to 0, you will get B is equals to mu naught I by 2 r capital R. And for coil, you can say into n, mu naught n I by 2 r. Okay, this is the magnetic field induction basically. Okay, then here related to this concept, what the things we have to remember for objective exam. Okay, there they may ask, Nana, by considering this one as a closed loop, okay, circular loop, what will be the magnetic moment when it is carrying the current? Okay, that magnetic moment here, the same formula by comparing this one, okay, with the magnetic field induction on the axial line of a bar magnet, okay, then you will get here, means by multiplying numerator and denominator with the 2 pi nano, then the denominator will be 4 pi by multiplying with the 2 pi and 2 pi. Okay, I n r square by 2 into r square plus r square whole power 3 by. Okay, then here, if you consider this one as a short bar magnet, short bar magnet means the radius, the size of the coil will be small. Radius is small in comparison. Here r square can be neglected. So you can write here this one as 2 times 2 mu naught pi r square into I n by, you will get 4 pi into, oh, there is no 2 here. 4 pi into r cube. Okay. This is appear like mu naught by 4 pi into 2 m by r cube in magnetism chapter. Okay. So by comparing the two equations here, you can write the magnetic moment of a circular coil is equals to, by comparing mu naught 4 pi 4 pi 2 2 r square, in place of m, what is there? I n into pi r square. Pi r square is the area of circular coil. So you can generalize this formula, okay, for any shaped coil. The magnetic moment is equals to, you can write it as n I a. For a loop, you can write it as I into a. Okay, related to this concept, they may ask, okay, instead of asking straight away the circular coil, they may ask one electron is revolving in one particular orbit. Okay, then what will be the magnetic field formed at the center of the nucleus and what will be the magnetic moment? Okay, then here we have to know, we can use the same formula only, okay, here and there to find out the magnetic moment. Okay, but we have to know what is the equivalent current produced by the moment of electron in circular orbit of radius some r. Okay, when electron is moving, suppose in anti-clockwise direction, all of you know the current will be produced in clockwise direction, in opposite direction. So the current produced here is equals to, we have to write according to the formula Q by T, I is equals to Q by T in current electricity. We have to write E by, T means time to complete one revolution around the nucleus, E by T. So if you put that I is equals to E by T, or you can write I is equals to E into 1 by T is the frequency, or here I is equals to E into 1 by T is nothing but T is 2 pi by omega, 2 pi by omega you can write, or I is equals to, you can write E by 2 pi into omega is equals to again V by R. From the formula V is equals to R omega in circular motion. Okay. So any formula you can use when you come to numericals. Suppose if they give the speed of electron, then you can write there. Okay. If they give angular velocity, if they give frequency, if they give time period, these formulae we use. Okay, suppose any one formula if I use at the center, then I can write B at the center of one orbit is equals to mu naught I. I is EV by 2 pi R. Means I am going to use this formula, EV by 2 pi R. Mu naught I, that is 2 R I write here. So B at center, straight away I am getting mu naught by 2 pi into 2 is 4 pi. E V by R square. This is the magnetic field induction at the center of one circular at the center of nucleus. Okay, when an electron is revolving around the nucleus. Okay, and if you want the magnetic moment, M you can write here. This is one odd bit. So there are no number of loops. So n is equals to 1. I is here. E by 2 pi into, I'm writing V by R again. Into area, I write here pi R square. Okay. Again, pi pi get cancelled. I'm getting what on a 1 R get cancelled. E V R by 2. This is magnetic. Okay. And here, they may ask related to this concept. When an electron is revolving around the nucleus, wisely think, Nana, this concept is actually related to circular motion. So the concept what they are asking from electromagnetism, they may link to circular motion and they may ask what will be the angular momentum also, not the magnetic moment that we know, angular momentum. Angular momentum means generally we write IL is equals to I omega, or since it is a point mass, you can use MVR, R cross P formula. From that R cross P, I can write MVR or L is equals to I omega. Anyone you can write. Means angular momentum, I can write it as, since it is a point mass, moment of inertia is MR square simply into omega, or I can write that one as MVR. Okay, so here related to that concept, when you come to means, one time what he asked, linking this concept with circular motion, what will be the ratio of angular momentum to magnetic moment? Okay, angular moment to magnetic moment means he is asking L by M is equals to how much? Okay, L, now I came to know it is MVR. By magnetic moment, I know it is EVR by 2, that is into 2. So you are getting what, Nana? 2 times into M by E. Okay. Or if you want this term in terms of specific charge, you can write the reciprocal term, that is magnetic moment or magnetic moment to angular momentum. I can write it as E by M by 2, means that is half E by, okay. And there is one advantage, Nana. Suppose instead of asking the ratio of magnetic moment to angular momentum, which is half M E by M, that is half Q by M actually. Q is the charge of that electron. Okay. So Q by M. So related to this one, suppose they ask, this is one circular disk, Nana. Okay. Circular disk, and it is possessing some charge Q. Okay, say capital Q, anything. Okay, and this charged disk, okay, non-conducting disk, Nana, means while placing this one in a medium, it is not losing any charge. Okay, so this non-conducting charged disk, suppose rotate, okay, means here this is one, the axis of rotation. Means about the axis passing through center and perpendicular to the plane. If it is rotated, then what will be the ratio of M to L, or find out the magnetic moment, or find out the magnetic field induction at its center, if they ask. Okay, how to solve these type of models? Very simple. We don't know about the what will be the magnetic field at the center when the circular disk is rotated, but we know when one some charge is rotating in a particular radius, what will be the magnetic field, what will be the magnetic moment, those two we know. So here, consider in this disk one circular loop of certain thickness, means I am going to integration, I think you understood. Okay, and this is the part what I am considering here. Okay, due to this part, Nana, okay, circular of radius, I don't know, let it be x. Since it is x, the thickness I am taking it as dx. So that area of this thick ring, area dA, I write it here as not pi x square, Nana, that you know. Area is equal to pi x square. If I differentiate, I will get dA is equals to 2 pi x into dx. So this is the area of the small part what I am taking here. Okay. And then if you know this area, then you can write the magnetic moment as M is equals to our formula I into area. Area means area of this part is 2 pi x into dx. Okay. When it is rotated, it is the magnetic moment you are getting. Okay. Sir, I don't know I, sir. Very good. I is equals to, again you write there using the same formula. I is equals to any one you try to substitute on. That is qv by 2 pi r. Okay. If you want to write this one, take care here. Then m is equals to here. Directly you can use better. Which one is the better one? I think after substituting already we derived this one. Better you take this formula, Nana. EVR by 2. That is E, the charge on this part, which is dQ. Okay. V into R divided by 2. Okay. And here also there is some bug, Nana. What is the bug, sir? The speed of every element here, if you consider another ring here, the speed will not be same, Nana. But all the rings rotate with the same angular velocity. That's why better convert that one in terms of angular velocity. So V is, I write it as R into omega, then I have to write it as R square omega. Okay, I think you understood now. Where R square is nothing but radius is x, what I assumed there, x square. For that I am writing dm. Okay. So here from this, I can write dm is equals to x square omega by 2 into dq, the charge on this part I have to write now. Okay. Again, since the charge is distributed uniformly, I can write for pi r square area, the charge is q naught. Okay. Whereas your area is dA, what you calculated here. For 2 pi x dx area, what will be the charge? Okay. That charge in this small shaded part, dq is equals to, I'm writing, 2 pi x dx into q by pi r square. Okay. So here pi pi cancel, that dq I am going to substitute, which is what, Nana, 2x dx into q by r square. Okay, so look at here, Nana, this is 2 2 cancel, I am getting q by r square into omega, they are constants, x into x square x cube dx. Okay, this is dm. So here, if they want, what will be the magnetic moment? Straight away, you can integrate the whole part. Okay. So here, by taking the integration, you can take the magnetic moment is equals to q omega by r square into x cube is integration x power 4 by 4 and the limits of that radius starts from 0 to r. Full radius is r, Nana, till here it is r. So 0 to r, then you are getting q omega into by r square into r power 4 by 4. So you are getting 1 by 4 q omega r square. Okay, look at the magnetic moment. When a charge is rotating in a circular orbit, the magnetic moment, according to this formula, you will get qvr by 2. If I write v is equals to r omega again, qv, v is r omega, okay? I am getting here qr square omega by 2. Whereas when disk is rotated, you are getting q omega r square, same thing. Instead of by 2, I am getting by 4, okay? And the angular momentum of this one, okay, according to the formula, this I omega, Nana. Why? Because disk is not a point mass. That's why I can't use MVR formula. So I try to use L is equals to I omega. So from that formula, L is equals to I into omega. I initially only I told Nana, the axis is passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane. About the axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane, in rotatory motion, the moment of inertia is mr square by 2 for a circular disc. Okay, for circular ring, okay, having a charge q, I is equals to passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane, this is mr square. Okay, for a ring it is mr square, for disc it is mr square by 2. Okay, but look at here, if you take m by l for the ring and for the disc, okay, m is q r square omega by 2, okay, by l, l is I omega, mr square I, this is I, into omega, then you will get, look at Nana, q by m, okay, into 1 by 2, that is q by 2m, q by 2m, you got that. And for circular disk also, once you check Nana, m by l is equals to, m is q omega r square by 4, by l is mr square by 2 into omega. Look at here, r square omega get cancelled, 2 2 times get cancelled, again you got here q by 2 into m. This is what I am saying. Okay, if you get such type of question again in mains exam, okay, without solving and without wasting any time here, straight away you can put the option q by 2m. Okay, if it is electron, E by 2m, if it is a ring, q by 2m, disc, q by 2m, sphere, q by 2m, cylinder, q by 2m, for any body, you can generalize that equation, the ratio of m by l is always q by m. Okay, here any doubt in this concept? Okay, and then here, suppose if they ask, means here what are the magnetic fields produced by circular ring and straight conductor, we discussed Nana, two models. Okay, now if you enter into the concept of force on a conductor or force on a loop, okay, force on a conductor, force on a charge part already we completed Nana. So force on a conductor. Force on a conductor is equals to, means when a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field like this. Okay. Whereas B already perpendicular to the board, and here it is current carrying conductor. Basically, formula you know, I into, if the length of conductor is L, L cross B. Okay. And here there is one beautiful shortcut Nana while applying this formula. Look at here, this is L bar. L bar means the length what you are measuring in vector form. In vector form between two points, while measuring in your mathematics, we have to measure in a straight line only. Means just like displacement, what I am saying. So here, in the magnetic field, okay, in this model, if they ask, since the length of the conductor is L, straight away you can say I L B, no need to write sine theta. I think you know why, because magnetic field is perpendicular to the board, sine 90. So straight away you can write this is bill, which is force now, sorry. F is equals to bill, straight away you can say. But what is the shortcut here? Suppose if I take one conductor, not like straight one, I take as a sine wave by considering the two parts as semicircles. Okay, actually in the sine wave, the two parts are not semicircles. Considering them as semicircles, each of radius r, okay, like this. What will be the mass force acting on this conductor when it is carrying current I? Okay, like this. Okay, in this case, actually, suppose if the conductor is not straight, we have to integrate this formula, Nana. means f is equal to, we have to write integral id dl sin theta, we have to write. But integration means again time killing only. So then what will be the shortcut to find the answer in a shortest way, sir? Okay, there simple what I told, in this formula only there is one small information for us. What is that? It is L bar. L bar means between the two ends of the conductor, what will be the displacement? Okay, this is the displacement. Displacement means till here you observe it is diameter 2r, and from here to there you observe it is also diameter 2r. So total length from here to there, don't take it as the length, Nana. Length means L bar you have to say. Like displacement in motion is straight line. So the displacement from here to there will be 2r plus 2r, 4r. So L, what we call it as effective length. L effective is equals to 4r. Therefore, without integration, I am saying the answer f is equals to bi into L in the formula bill. L is 4r, sir, over. Okay, this is the answer. So in the same way, suppose this is one part of circle, means one arc given like this, making an angle theta at the center. Okay, and it is carrying the current I. What is the magnetic force on that conductor, sir? Means application of bill. Right? So what is the force means? We have to find out what is the effective length here. That effective length you can say from your mathematics, half of the angle will be, I write it as theta by 2, half angle. Okay? And here this is the radius of the circular part, arc, radius r. So here I require the opposite side. Opposite side means I write the sine theta is equals to, if I take the opposite side as x, okay, sine theta by 2 equals to x by radius. Then x is equals to, I'm getting r sine theta by 2, Nana. So total length, effective length between the two ends is x plus x, total 2x. So L effective here, I write it as 2 times 2x is r sine theta by 2. 2x, which is equals to 2r sine theta by 2. Okay, that implies force acting on the conductor is equals to bi. L effective is 2r sine theta by 2. Okay. So here problem is, when you take full circle, Nana, full circle means the angle at center becomes 360 degrees. 360 degrees means 360 by 2, that will become 180. 180 means sine 180 is equals to 0. That's why if you close the loop, the force on any closed loop, why? Because any closed loop in a plane, irrespective of the shape. In mathematics, we say the angle at the center will be 360 degrees, which is 2 pi radians. Okay? If such type of closed loop carrying some current I, if you place, okay, carrying some current I, straight away you can say that, sir, here theta is 360, sir, then the force on the conductor is equals to 0, sir. Don't say BIL or don't say BI into length of closed loop circle is 2 pi r, so don't say VI into 2 pi r. These two are wrong, Nana. Then F is equals to, straight away you can say 0. Okay? If force on closed loop is 0, then what they ask, if they give the closed loops in numericals. Okay? Then one time he asked, what it is one closed circular loop, Nana. Okay? Oh. Can I extend 10 minutes more?
Okay, sir.
No problem.
No problem, sir.
Right, right. Then here in this case, Nana, suppose this is one closed circular loop and it is the magnetic field. Okay, carrying the current. The force is 0. That's why there is no force. Okay, but if you select each element in the conductor, means in this closed loop, it will experience some tension, like compressive tension or elongated tension. Some tension it will experience. That tension they may ask. Okay. So if you come to that tension here, suppose this is one closed circuit placed in a magnetic field, taking the magnetic field inwards. Okay. And here taking the current, suppose in clockwise direction, right? And I am selecting one element somewhere here or there. This is one small element what I am taking. Okay. And that element of length, I am taking it as a dl. It is placed in a magnetic field. Since it is small element, I can take it as a straight conductor. Then force straight away, I can say F on that one is equal, which is actually dF, is equals to BI into DL. No need to write sin theta in this case. Okay. And here that force acts in what direction means, again, I have to use what the Fleming's left hand rule. D is into, but current is towards here, tangentially towards left. This is the direction of current. You are getting the force downwards. So it is trying to elongate in this closed road, in that magnetic field. So it is elongative force. That's why immediately while trying to elongate, each element experience force outwards like this at any part, means each element getting the force like this, elongative force. Then immediately the loop tries to create some tension again to bring it back. So tension to bring it back means that this element tangentially, you will get the tension here. Okay. And here also you will get the tension tangentially like this. Okay. So these two tensions at the two ends here, trying to again bring it back. Okay. To counterpoise means to balance the elongative force. So look at the force and tensions are not in the same direction. That's why what will be the component you will get in opposite direction to balance the force. For that, what I'm taking at the center, suppose for my convenience, the angle will be some 2 d theta I'm taking. Why? Because it is small angle. I'm taking the angle as d theta, total 2 d theta. Then half angle will be d theta. Okay, then here look at Nana, for this it is the corresponding perpendicular for the vertical line, for the radius it is the corresponding perpendicular tangent. So the angle between these two will be the same, which is d theta. So if I resolve tension into two components, I will get a t cos d theta here. There also I will get t cos d theta getting in opposite direction. These two get cancelled. They are resulting nothing. Then which component will be balanced by the force or the other component here and there? You will get what component, you know, this is a T sine D theta. That is also T sine D theta. Both will act in opposite direction to the force. So this force is balanced by the 2 times 2 T sine D theta. Okay. So 2t sine d theta, you can write it as a d theta. Nana. Why? Because already I took the angle is very small. So sine d theta is d theta is equals to, I got bi dl. Okay. Again, use the sector principle from the sector. Nana. Angle is equals to total angle 2 d theta. Angle equals to arc length dl by radius. So 2 d theta I can replace with dl by r. So t into dl by r is equals to bi dl. So dl dl cancel, Nana. The tension in this circular loop when it is carrying some current I and placed in a magnetic field. The tension, not the force, Nana. Force is zero. The tension in the loop, any shaped loop, T is equals to, I am getting BI into R. Okay. Here, based on this model, Nana, again in 2019, I think, he asked, tried to confuse, just trying to confuse only. He gave one part only, means one sector here given, and it is placed in a magnetic field. Okay, and its radius is given, trying to confuse us. He gave the angle also theta, means sector angle is given as 2 theta here, and it is carrying some current, clock or anti-clock. What is the tension in the wire, he asked. Okay, tension in the wire, I already calculated here for small element. Finally, look at here, that length term get cancelled. Length term get cancelled means the tension in the wire is independent of length of the loop. Independent of length means whether it is a full circle or part of circle, the tension will be same. That's why don't waste the time here. If you derive again, you will get in the same way. Again, I have to assume one small element. Again, force is equal to BIDL. Again, resolving the two tensions at the two ends, I will get the same terms. And finally, again, I will get what? T into BIR only. That's why if you know this concept, straight away you can put the answer for this question, even in mains exam. T is equals to, oh, sir already told, it is independent of length of the loop. Independent of length. Oh, he tried to confuse, given some theta here, this is unnecessary data. Therefore, T is equals to, you can put the option BIR. This is the tension. Okay. So, today we covered